The projection command in Shaper 3D is also very powerful. With the projection command, we can project the shape or the outline of a face into a sketch, or project a sketch into a face and slice it. So let's take a look at how this works. From this flat surface, I will create a plane and move this plane up a little bit. Then I will select this face one more time, shift click this construction plane I created, and then select the project command. And you see here we have two options, edges and sketch. Sketch is only the one that makes sense because we are projecting geometry into a sketch. And click done. I will go ahead and actually hide this plane so it's much easier to see the sketch we just created. So that is a projected sketch. This is very useful when you then want to create actually more controlled interface design versions. I would like onto these three buttons, elements to be projected onto, so I can change the material. Currently, when we zoom in, you see this is just a solid face. So I will go to the sketch, go to top view so I can look straight down. I go to circle, select the center, and draw one circle and draw a second circle and exit the sketch. As you can see now, we have two new sketch elements added, which I can select. And then I shift select also the target face, go to more and select project. And this time, the logical selection here is edges. So the circles in the sketch are being projected down onto the geometry, and where it intersects, it slices actually the sketch. It slices the geometry into individual elements. I can now go to the visualization command and zoom in, find this new cut, and then assign a new material. If I go back to modeling, and because everything is parametric, I can go ahead and change the dimensions of the sketch. And then this, well, as you can see, also adjust the projection and the material look. Working very efficiently is also very useful when working with sketches. I would like to have a plus and a minus added actually onto these two buttons. So I go to the sketch, I go to top view, zoom in a little bit, rectangle from center, and there is one rectangle. I will say 2 by 5, that is perfect. And then I will do another rectangle and a third rectangle, but I don't really enter dimensions. Press escape. Take a look at what I'm doing now. I'm selecting all three short edges, and then I say equal. And then I will select all long edges and I say equal. I will also one more time select three elements from these rectangles and add a horizontal vertical constraint to make sure that these rectangles don't rotate. Because now I can go ahead and say this should be 1 millimeter, and you see how everything is being updated. Because the constraint system equal makes sure that the shape of these two rectangles is always the same as the first rectangle. Then we can exit the sketch. This time I select the sketch profile, select the target surface, project, and then I do the same on top. Here I need to make sure that everything is correct. So you see how I made sure that all the sketches should be projected onto the target. and as edges, and done. Very good. What I can do now with this is these selected profile sketches. I can select and then extrude or extrude inwards. Let's make a little bit of a haptic effect. Go to visualize and then change the material. Beautiful. So this is actually how easy it is to project geometry into a sketch or project a sketch onto geometry. So we can change materials or, for example, continue extruding and 3D modeling interface elements.